There was a ruling from a UK court that says Uber drivers are employees and they're not freelancers, they're not contractors. And this is a big deal for Uber because it's been arguing exactly the opposite for exactly for however long it's been around, for a number of years now. So what this ruling means is that Uber drivers are entitled to things like vacation days and sick days and minimum wage and other workers' rights. But these things are, of course, expensive for Uber, which is why it's been arguing that its employees are contractors. This is something that helps keep Uber's costs low, which of course gives it an advantage over taxis. So right now, Uber, it's in Toronto, it's in Ottawa, it's in Montreal, it's in Edmonton, it's negotiating to operate in Calgary and Winnipeg and Saskatoon, and of course, you know all about Vancouver. Uber has some supporters, it's got a lot of detractors, it's not yet in Vancouver, but it's got lobbyists who are working hard to do that. So when we step back and look at Canada within the broader context of Uber and how it's rolled out in countries around the world, we're not as far down the path with Uber as some cities like, say, a London are. So far, Canadian cities have focused on issues like insurance and background checks for drivers, and these things are important, they certainly are. You look at what's going on in the UK, you look at what's going on in London, they've gone through those discussions, and now their concerns are really on the next level. They're looking at things like what happens to Uber drivers, what happens to workers in the so-called gig economy. If fewer people moving forward are going to have full-time jobs, traditional full-time jobs, what's going to happen to things like pension plans? What's going to happen to CPP contributions, to OAS contributions? Who's going to pay for these types of things? So if you're an Uber supporter out there and you want Uber to come to Vancouver, that's fine. If you've used Uber in other cities, you like getting a cheaper ride, that's great. I mean, nobody's really going to criticize you for that because it's a good service. At the same time, you look at this court ruling, which Uber, of course, is going to appeal, and it does point to the larger ramifications of getting that cheaper ride. That's what cities like London are now looking at, and the further along we go with Uber in Canada, those are questions that our cities are going to have to look at as well.
Well, cheaper ride is one thing here. The conversation really is there just simply aren't enough taxis. We just need a ride sometimes. The taxis are often not to be found.